What does it take to stop someone who has faced 71 overs out of 240 by himself, then near single-handedly went on to save the test for his country, arguably becoming the best overseas batsman against spin in India right now? What does it take to stop him? The answer? A sharp captain, a clever bowler, and two perfectly timed balls. Today, let's see how India broke the big New Zealand wall. Test matches are like chess games, where moves are traded back and forth. Tricks, measures and countermeasures are devised and employed throughout the series. But above all, what matters is studying the opponent, understanding what makes them tick, and through that, find the flaw. Now, Tom Latham, our opponent this time, is not an exciting batsman, not in the traditional sense. Though being an opener, he doesn't destroy the opponent with the flair of Sehwag or Jayasurya, or even the calculated aggression of Straw or Saurabh Tapatu. But what he does do, quite well I might add, is plan. In his own words, it's important to have different game plans for different conditions and try to stick to that. This statement was originally uttered by a 25-year-old. 25! And this game plans are tailor-made for pitches, time of the day, and even individual bowlers. He will go over each and every bowler's pitch map, creating a rough batting plan against them, making the mental switch necessary for each bowler. This mental switch, or should I say mental stubbornness, is the hallmark of the Latham way. Let's take the example of the first match. The pitch wasn't a rank turner by any means, but it had enough on it to make it tricky, especially given the fact that New Zealand would have to bat in the fourth inning. Add to that the quality of Indian bowlers. Ian Botham summarized the situation perfectly. This matchup is so lopsided that it isn't even funny at this point. And it was in this unfunny situation that walked in opener Tom Latham and put his plan to action. The plan was simple: make the opponent play on my strength. Now Latham himself would say that his repertoire on the offside against spin is fairly lacking. But what he lacks in offense, he more than makes up in defense. From front foot movement to being on top of the ball, it is a lesson in defending against spin. And it's a lesson that has been learned and perfected over the last 5 years when he had been caught 4 times while trying to defend in the same way by Ashwin. Today, he has improved to the point of being able to defend all day long, on and on, and that's exactly what happened. As long as the ball was outside off, Latham was more than happy to play maiden after maiden, no cuts unless and until the ball is really short and wide, no drives unless it is a gifted half ball. Other than that, defend, defend and defend. And wait. Wait for the bowler to get frustrated and ball a bit closer and then just sweep it. That's not even counting his ability to come down the pitch as and when he wants, but only when the ball is a bit closer. So, after being hit once or twice, the bowler will switch to bowling wide again and Latham will start defending again, and on we go. Both innings combined, he scored a total of 71 runs against spinners. In those 71, 63 came on the leg side. This sounds easy on paper, but it's nothing but playing spin on the subcontinent. You're bound to get beaten every now and then. Now it's human nature to get flustered by such misses and wanting to respond to that either by attacking the ball or correcting your mistakes. Such near misses and small corrections tend to slowly accumulate over a period of time, resulting in a gross miscalculation. Latham, on the other hand, seems to be the living, breathing definition of being stubborn as a mule. No matter the misses, no matter the miscalculation, he will keep on playing the same defense, the same play style with an eerie accuracy. It's like throwing stone in mercury. There's not even a splash. Especially in the fourth inning, with a match on the line, he faced a total of 146 balls, out of which 104 were against spinners. That's the most balls faced by a non-Asian batsman in the fourth inning in India since 2017. So in short, Tom Latham is a mountain. Unmovable, unshakable, and unless and until he plays a careless shot, unbreakable. So, how exactly was the mountain broken? Well, in the first innings of the second test at least, the mountain was trapped by pure Kohli magic. Now back in the first test, where Rahane was the captain, for whatever reason, the entire Indian bowling lineup had failed to bowl a single short pitch delivery to Latham. Virat had quickly zeroed in on that coming onto this test, and banking on Latham not anticipating a bouncer, he built a trap. It started with Umesh Yadav and Mohammad Siraj. The instruction was, just go and do your usual things. Same length and back of the length balls, same line, and basically the same result as the last time. But coming into the fourth over, that trap was sprung. Siraj was told, when you feel it's right, aim for his head. After two balls, Siraj did just that, but the aim was off. Ball went way above Latham's head, who quickly dug below it. The aspect of surprise was gone. Latham knew the plan, he knew what to expect, but what he didn't expect was that the very next ball would again be a bouncer. This time, at the perfect length, perfect height, on the perfectly tantalizing spot, waiting to be hooked. And waiting for it was the perfect field. Square leg had been pushed back for this exact shot, and Latham, wanting to answer the challenge, gave in to the temptation. And here was the second trick. In analyzing last match, most of the team management came up with a simple theory. Latham is most shaky right at the start. The more he plays, the steadier he gets. So hit him fast, hit him hard, and hit him early. Latham, in the fourth over itself, having not played bouncers in Indian conditions, failed to middle the bat. And the ball went down Iyer's throat. The mountain had been broken once, through a surprise and a nearly perfectly executed trap. But this is a test. The batsman is gonna get a second chance, and this time the bouncer won't work. Latham made sure of it. He had sifted through India's bowling footage at night, even practiced a few light drills in the morning. Now he would be ready for the bouncer. But in that day and night, his team, Captain Tom Latham's team this time, had hit choppy waters. First, they got bundled out for a mere 62. Now they were facing the mammoth total of 540 on day 3 of the test. So basically, it was going to be a repeat telecast of the last match, this time with a bigger target. With all hopes pinned not on the opener Tom Latham, but just captaining his fourth test, stand-in captain Tom Latham. The pressure replacing that one word brings is simply unimaginable. Combined with the fact that yes, he could prepare for bouncers, but what about the bigger issue, the shaky start issue? Well, arguably the cleverest spinner in the world today decided to put it to test. Ashwin, coming in from the second over itself, started usual run-of-the-mill off-spin. 10 balls straight of standard off-spin. Some got hit, some got defended, but the ball didn't change. Now comes the 11th ball, and Ashwin simply shortens its length by a bit, straightening the ball by a bit. And lo and behold, Latham misses it. Still, he's able to hold the ball down somehow, facing the next ball, a length ball with absolutely no spin on it. Latham plays for the spin. And that's it. He's gone. Now I can't say for sure what exactly did him in. Was it the pressure or the early jitters or a momentary lapse in concentration? But the fact remains that the same changeup that Latham had masterfully handled in the last test had duped him the very first time he faced it this time. He had gotten out in the fourth over in both the innings. The mountain had fallen and New Zealand was on their way to the slaughterhouse. Understand what happened here though. One batsman first single-handedly saved a test match for his country, and come the second test, extensive plans were laid down to specifically hammer down that particular nail. Just like a chess match, moves were analyzed and studied and countered across matches. That's the beauty of tests. Winning or losing one session or a test is like winning a battle. In the end, when all said and done, it doesn't matter. What matters is who wins the war. In the end. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you have a good day.